Turn to Proverbs 4. And we're going to be reading verse 5 through 10. Proverbs 4, verses 5 through 10.
Amen.
Proverbs 4.
Amen.
Verse 5 through 10.
Amen.
Amen.
And it reads, get wisdom, get understanding, forget it not, neither decline from the words of my mouth. Forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. Love her, and she shall keep thee. Wisdom is the principal thing, therefore get wisdom. And with all thy getting, get understanding. Exalt her, and she shall promote you, promote thee. She shall bring thee to honor when thou dost embrace her. She shall give to thine heart an ointment of grace, a crown of glory shall she deliver to thee. Hear, O my sons, and receive my sayings. And the years of thy life shall be many.
All right now.
You may take your seat.
All right now. Amen.
First, giving honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and to the ministers on the roster, the deacons, members, and friends that are here today. We're going to speak on a simple subject, wisdom can be learned. Wisdom can be learned. You know, in 1 Timothy, Paul tells us we're living in some perilous times. And if you look at everything that is happening, it is happening because people are not walking in the Word of God, walking according to the Word of God. And they sit around and worry about the politicians and what they are doing in Washington, D.C., what they're doing in the capital over Jackson. But the main thing is to look at what you are doing. Whether you are doing what God has called you to do.
Yes.
The Bible says many are chosen, but a few are called. And if you have been called by God, it will show up in your life.
Amen.
You understand? And when it show up in your life, you're going to have to be a light to someone else so it can show up in their life.
Amen.
But a lot of us do a whole lot of talk, but there's no substance behind your talk.
You tell it.
See, we have to be an example as Jesus was to us.
Amen.
And now this book of Proverbs here was written by Solomon. And the purpose was to teach people how to obtain wisdom and discipline and a prudent life and know to do what is right and just and fair in the eyesight of God.
That's right.
And so to apply thy divine wisdom to daily life and provide moral instructions.
Yes.
See, Solomon wrote this.
That's right.
And he became king at a teenage age.
Yes.
Right.
And where he had to serve the Lord. And be over God's people.
Yeah.
God told Solomon, said, now ask for whatever you want, and I'll give it to you.
He
asked for wisdom. He could have asked, most of us would ask for give me $1 million. But he asked for wisdom.
My God.
And God gave him to be the wisest man on the earth. And the idea, Solomon instructed the young men of their daily life as a father. See, we ought to be father figures
yes,
to the younger ones, men. And ladies have to be a mother figure to the younger.
Okay?
And he gave this, giving advice to his son, Solomon. David did. While many of these problems are directed toward young men, the principles supporting them are helpful to all believers.
Amen.
If you do what God tells you to do,
right now,
things will work out.
Amen.
God wants his people to be wise.
Come on.
He don't want you to be walking around here blind and don't know what's going on. Two kinds of people portray two characters, contrasting paths of life. Uh-huh. Everybody's life is not the same.
Amen.
We all going to have our own gifts that we use for the edification of God's word. But God going to give us wisdom how to walk through each one of them. To relate to people, we need to continue to be tactful and to have discipline and to use the wisdom that God gives us if we desire to live according to God's word.
Yeah.
So simply Solomon is telling us that wisdom can be learned if we seek after it. And the word says to us, anyone that lacks wisdom, ask of God. Ask of God. First Timothy 6:10 tells us the love of money is the root of all evil. But why do all of us seek money in unrighteous ways other than calling on the Lord and let him guide you?
Come on.
See, a lot of us think that we have to get it for ourselves. But the Lord has told us he got the cattle on a thousand hills and that he will supply all that we need. But look at us. We think we got to hustle and bustle. You can have three jobs, but yet the bills are not being paid. Because your life is raggedy. You're more catered to that job than you are to God. If you just pick up the Bible and open it up for instructions, he will guide you and you will receive everything that you need. You see, 1 Kings 10 tells us that even the Queen of Sheba, when she heard the great things that Solomon was doing at a young age, she had to come and see it for herself.
Yeah.
What was the great things he was doing? He was building the temple of God. He brought the wood and everything from all over the world. He was doing some magnificent things. His people were fat.
Yes.
They wasn't slavery, but they were fat and working for the Lord. So the Queen of Sheba came by to see what he was doing. And she said, surely God is with this man. See, people know whether God is with you by the way that you walk in your life. But I want you to understand Galatians 6:7. Be not deceived, for God is not mocked.
That's right.
Whatsoever man sows, that also he shall reap. So if you sowing goodness, my sister and brother, goodness gonna come to you.
Yes,
and you're gonna reap it abundantly.
Yes.
But if you're sowing evil, the same thing is going to happen evil. And then always in Matthew 7 and verse 13 and 14, he tells us simply, there are two ways to eternity. One is the straight and narrow way. And there is going to be few there. And the other one is the broad way to destruction. The broad way to destruction means that you're doing things that is not of God, and you're going to kill yourself And whoever is fighting you going to get killed also.
My God.
I don't mean physically killed, but you'll be spiritually cut off from God.
Yes.
Now, let's look at this Proverbs 4 today. Look what he says, start with the first words. He said, hear ye children, the instructions of a father attend to no understanding. For I give you good doctrine, forsake not my law. Now, David was his father, and David was instructing him to forsake his law that he had learned from God.
Yeah.
So he was teaching his son, and his son is now passing it on to younger men. And he said, for I was my father's son, and tender, and only beloved in the sight of my mother. Mm-hmm. Mother's love. Is something else. But mother has to be the example that God wants her to be. See, if you're smoking and drinking, don't you know the mother, the child is gonna pick it up? If you're lying and cheating, the child gonna be picking up also, mother. He taught me also and said unto me, let thine heart retain my word, keep my commandments and live. Now, what did I tell you? If you walk with God, he's already told you, Father Abraham, that he's going to be a blessing and to everybody, and he's going to bless you to be a blessing. So stop worrying about that voice and pay attention to what God is trying to tell you.
Amen.
The devil uses all kinds of things to take your mind off the word. So we have to stay focused, okay? He taught me also and said unto me, let thine heart retain my words. Keep the commandments and live. Do y'all know what the commandments are?
Love one another.
No, the first God gave said, I am the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not have no other God before me. I am a jealous God. Don't you know if he's jealous and got all power, what he can do to you?
My God.
Hello? And then he says, bow down to no carved image. Why are we bowing down to things on this earth? People worried about how the church building is. It's not the church building. It's the you, what's in your heart. The heart that you have for God. Amen?
Yes, Lord.
And then he said, now, get wisdom and get understanding and forget it not. You don't forget what's in this Bible. Don't go about it trying to do it on your own, what you think it should be about. Let the Spirit reveal to you what it is. One of the big things we have is raising children. We don't understand what the word says. But look at Proverbs 22 and 6.
All right,
it says, train up a child in the way that it should go. When it's old, he won't stay fluffy. Hello?
Amen.
But I want you to look at Proverbs 23 and verse 13.
All right.
Speak, Lord.
Proverbs 23 and verse 13. And it reads, withhold not correction from the child.
What you mean, doctor?
Hello? Withhold not correction from the child. But what most of us want to do, instead of doing what God wants to do, we be hollering at them. We cuss them out. Tell them they ain't no good. They'll be like the no good daddy. But look what the Bible says. Look what the Bible says. Withhold not correction from the child. If thou beatest him with the rod, He shall not what? Die. Do y'all know what it means?
Yeah.
That means beaten don't mean excessively, but correct that child in a manner when he will understand.
Amen.
But we don't let the thing called government take the word of God and got their own law. Come on, call 911 on mama and dad.
Jesus.
I wouldn't want. If you put the right rod on his behind, all he's gonna do is call mama and daddy. Whoever's beating him, he's gonna say,
Lord, get him.
He's gonna call him, Lord, mama, come and get me.
Yes, Lord. Preach,
help us, Lord.
We have to understand God's word.
Amen.
But we put more prudence in the things of this world than we do in the word of God.
Uh-huh.
And another thing is that we do a lot of worry.
Sure do.
Amen.
Yes.
We do a lot of worry because we don't trust God.
Hey.
Come on, help
us. Well, that's why when things happen, you don't need to hold out a lip service.
Come on, doctor.
Just trust God.
Speak to us.
You know, a lot of times, some of you know, when you come in the middle of problems, I said, why are you doing talking?
Give it to the Lord.
Let's pray about it.
Yes.
Let's give it to God and put it in his hand and listen to what he tell you.
Yeah.
You know, when we want to get all excited, think we got to do this or do that to get out of trouble.
Amen.
He done told you he will cover you.
Mm-hmm.
He's your buckle.
All right.
He's your shield.
Amen.
He's your wheel.
Yes,
he's your shelter in a time of a storm.
Yes, Lord.
But you got to trust in him.
Yes,
and lean not to your what? Own understanding.
Amen.
He said, now, forsake her not, and she shall preserve thee. Right?
Right.
Love her, and she shall keep thee. You know what preserve me?
Mm-hmm.
That she will stay in wisdom and knowledge and see that what God is that track. That God have your own.
Amen.
And you will continue to preserve it and follow what God has given
you. Thank
you,
Lord. Thank you.
And she shall keep thee. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. And with all thy getting, get understanding.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
If you don't know what you're reading at home, come to Bible study.
Amen.
Come to Sunday school.
Amen.
And come to church so you can get the understanding.
Yes.
If you look at our world, the reason our kids are they killing each other so much, we forgot to do what God told them to do.
Right.
Where are they? You didn't bring them to church. But as I told you many times, when I was growing up, I was on drugs. My mother drugged me to church every Sunday.
Amen.
I didn't have no choice.
Come on.
Hey, man, say that.
Right.
It wasn't no get up, James. No, I was up. When I heard mama, I was up.
Mm.
Getting dressed.
That's God.
And when it was time to leave, I was standing at the car door opening for her.
All right.
Because she trained me up right.
Come on, Doc.
Right.
And then when I strayed away from it when I went to the army.
Yeah, yeah.
And got them bullets start flying to Vietnam. I call on the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Because she had taught me about Jesus.
Thank you, Mother.
And I got to know him for myself.
Yes.
And the bullets were flying.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, cover me. And guess what?
He
covered me.
Yes.
Still here. Still here.
Yeah.
And he said, now, it's on her. And she shall promote you. Promote thee. She shall bring thee to honor when thou dost embrace her. When you get a hold of God's word,
you better say it.
Stop worrying about this job or that.
Amen.
Because God is going to promote you.
Amen.
When he sees fit.
Amen.
Amen.
It ain't about your resume.
Amen.
It's about your life.
Yes.
Who are you hooked to?
Amen.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
Are you doing drugs? Are you doing alcohol?
All right.
Are you stealing?
All right.
These are the things that matter.
Yes.
Matter of whether you get promoted. Because if you go out against the commandments of God,
yes, Lord,
there is no promotion.
Yes.
You understand? Yes. I was reading an article in the newspaper by the lady that left a good job in California and came all the way here to Mississippi, thought it was about something. And in 6 months, she lost the job.
My God.
And see, she admitted herself that the Spirit told her, don't do it.
All right now.
But she was looking at M-O-N-E-Y.
Oh, my God.
Hello?
All right now.
See, you got to stop looking at M-O-N-E-Y and start listening to the Word of God.
Yes.
I read it again. It said, now, exalt her, and ye shall what? Be promoted.
Mm-hmm.
We think we got to do all kinds of schemes and everything to be promoted.
Yes.
God gives you promotion.
Yes, he does.
Through your relationship with him.
Amen.
She said, bring the honor. He will give you, he will exalt you in due time.
Yes.
If we just have patience.
Yes.
And wait on him.
Yes.
When thou dost embrace her, when you get it, you will have that patience.
Yes.
You will wait on God.
Yeah,
you stand back and do God's will with what you have.
Yeah.
Then the next thing you know, there is a breakthrough.
Yes.
But don't believe these people out here talking about prosperity.
All right.
Teaching you prosperity. All your prosperity comes through the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 9, she said, give to thee to thine head an ointment of grace. David says, he anointed my head
with oil.
With oil.
And my cup.
And my cup, right?
Ooh.
Now. See what that means? You
yes.
got it.
Yes.
It's going to be poured out to others.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And it said, now, and when thou, and a crown of glory shall she deliver to thee. Ain't somebody a crown put on your head.
All right.
People will know who you are.
Amen.
You can walk up and people say, oh, wait, I can feel the Spirit of him when you walk.
Yes, amen.
God reveals all things to his people.
Yeah.
Amen.
And those that are sick, I say to you, don't get caught up in the things of this world, because worry will kill you.
Amen. Amen.
Hello? In verse 10 it said, hear, my son, and receive my sin, my saying, and the years of thy life
shall be
many.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
sir.
You see, I see right now in this country,
yes,
we have a thing called forgetfulness.
Uh-huh.
We have a thing of faithlessness.
Mm-hmm.
And failure in our life. Simply because we're not living according to the Word of God.
Yes.
When you get to failure,
yes,
you're on your last leg. But I tell you, just remember, I have taught thee in the way of wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
I have led thee in right pace, path.
Uh-huh.
When thou goest, thy steps shall not be what? Strengthened thee. And when thou runnest, thou shalt not stumble.
My God.
Walking with God.
Yes.
He gives you all power.
Yes, he does.
Jesus said very simply, I am the way,
the truth,
and the life.
Yes, Lord.
No man can make it to the Father
except
by through me. That means without Jesus in your life,
you can't do nothing.
You're not going to make it to the King.
Yes.
Amen.
I don't care how much money you have in the bank.
You better save it.
You can't buy it.
You're saving it up.
When the time comes for judgment,
Jesus.
Your money don't mean nothing.
My God.
I have buried them from one day old to 105 years old.
Yes.
And I haven't seen no U-Haul go behind into the rain.
Yes.
You can't take it with you.
Amen. Amen.
But you can use it for the edification of God's word while you're here.
Yeah.
Amen. So now, when thou goest, thy steps shall be not be strained.
Yes.
And when thou runnest, thou shalt not stumble.
Yes.
So whatever you do for the Lord,
my God,
you're not going to stumble.
Amen.
You call those things as they were.
Not
as though they were.
Yes, Lord.
And he's going to make things happen.
Oh, yes.
And he said, now,
thank you, Lord. Oh,
thank you, Jesus. Take fast hold of instruction.
Yes, Lord.
Let her not go. Keep her, for she is thy life.
Yes.
Without Christ, you are not living.
Jesus.
Tell it again, Doc.
Jesus.
Without Christ,
you are not living.
Yeah, yes. Enter not in the path of weakness.
Yeah.
And go not in the way of evil men.
All right now.
To sum it all up, y'all.
Yes.
Wisdom can be learned.
Can be learned.
If you seek the word for yourself.
Amen. Amen.
Matthew 6:33. Matthew 6:32 says, God already knows what you need.
Yes.
But 33 says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
And his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you.
Yes,
wisdom can be learned.
Yes, Lord.
And I say, except you know Jesus Christ for yourself,
Amen.
You will not understand
the
word. What I'm saying.
Amen.
And what I'm saying to you, get to know Mary's baby.
Yes.
The Bible says he came down to 42 generations.
Oh, yes.
He did it.
He walked on this earth for 33 years. And he talked for 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
He came to his own.
But his own received.
Did not recognize him.
My God.
Those that were looking for him did not understand.
Yes.
And one day, he rode into Jerusalem.
Yes, Lord.
On a donkey. Mm.
My God.
And they were laying down palm trees. Leaves in their clothes and saying, Hosanna to the highest.
My God.
Which is God is with, save us. And the Bible says next Thursday, that same crowd.
That same crowd.
Was saying, crucify him.
My Lord. My God.
Crucify him.
Mm-hmm.
And they took my father. Out of the Garden of Gethsemane.
Yes.
And took him to Caiaphas' house.
Sure did.
And they beat him up.
Uh-huh.
Spit on him.
Yeah.
Talked about him.
Yes.
All the things, evil things that they could do.
Yes.
But my father never said a one mumbling word.
No.
Then they took him from there
uh-huh.
to Pilate's house.
Yes.
Who was the governor.
Yes.
And because they didn't have the power
mm-hmm.
to kill it.
Mm-hmm.
When you're living under the power of man,
uh-huh.
you have no authority.
No.
And Pilate said, why y'all bring him to me? Pilate said, because he's preaching another doctrine.
My God.
Different from ours. Mm-hmm. See, a lot of us today is living by the doctrine of man.
Yeah.
But I come by to tell you, wisdom can be learned.
Yes.
By the things that you go through.
Yes.
So I say to you, Paul said, well, I'm going to question it and see what's going on with it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Paul said, are you the king of the Jews?
Yeah.
He said, you said.
You said?
And Paul said, bring me a pail of water.
Because
I find no fault in this man.
My God.
I'm going to wash my hands.
Yes.
Of doing it at home.
Yes, Lord.
Then they took him back to Caiaphas' house. They beat him up. They put a crown of thorns
on his head. Yes, Lord.
And on a Friday morning,
yeah.
They paraded him through the city of Jerusalem. I run. God live.
Yes, Jesus. Jesus.
It can be learned.
You can.
By seeking the word.
Put it down.
To
Father, Lord, Jesus.